Hello students, welcome to our class. Hope you are all fit and fine. I think you have watched, enjoyed and got an idea about our previous video. Let us recap once before we start our today's session. In the previous video, we have learnt about pronouns. Pronouns can replace nouns. Nouns are naming words. Names of a person, place, animal or thing. So here, now I am going to announce the answers of previous session allotted homework for you. Exercise B, page number 48 in your grammar and more. I believe everyone have completed the assigned work. Exercise B, fill in the blanks with the correct pronouns. First one, me. Second one, them. Third one, us. Fourth one, we. Fifth one, her. Sixth one, it. Seventh one, it. Eighth one, they. Fifth one, her children. Sixth one, it. Seventh one, it. Eighth one, they. I have repeated once again from 5 to 8. Check carefully. Exercise C. First one, yours. Second one, mine. Third one, mine. Fourth one, hers. Fifth one, mine. Sixth one, his. Seventh one, mine. Exercise D. First one, they have already given. Second one, where were you born? Third one, who calls you with the name Mahi? Or, what do your teammates call you? In two ways you can write the question. Fourth one. When was your debut? Fifth one. What are your hobbies? Or what do you like to do in leisure time? Sixth one. What is your mantra in life? Seven. What was your proudest moment? Reflexive pronouns, exercise E, matching, E, F, B, C, A, D. Exercise F, circle the demonstrative pronouns and underline the words they stand for. First one, circle this. Underline present. That circled. Jyoti Randhava. Underlined. 3. Apples. Underlined. Those. Circled. 4. Circle this. Underline Abhirasha. 5. Circle this. Underline omelette. 6. Circle those. Underline Nalanda University. 7. Circle this. Underline Lima. 8. Underline Jasmith. Circle this. 9. Circle that. Underline school. 10. Underline cushions. Circle these. Now see exercise G. First one, something. 2. Anything. 3. Something. 4. Everything. 5. Something. 6. Anybody. 7. Everyone. 8. No one. 9. Some. 10. Many. H. Someone. First one, someone. 2. Anyone. 3. Somebody. 4. No one. 5. Anyone's. 6. Everyone. Now see exercise I. 1. Who. 2. That. 3. Who. 4. That. 5. Whose. 6. That. 7. whose, 8, which, 9, that, 10, that, 11, who. Twelve, who. 13, who. 14, who. 15, who. 16, that. 17, who. 18, who. Exercise J. First one, underline that, my. Second one, any. 3, his, the. 4, many, a. 5, which. 6, who's that. 7, a few. 8, my, the. 9, the. 10, every, a. 11, a and his, that. 12th one, some, the, that. 13th one, our, the. 14th one, a, the. 15th one, your. That's it, children. So, I have completed announcing the answers of your previous allotted homework. Let us commence our today's session. Today, I am going to teach you Unit 4 in your textbook, What Can a Dollar and 11 Cents Do? It is the title of the lesson. So, what can you understand by listening the title of the lesson? What can a dollar and 11 cents do? You can understand it is a very minimum amount or small amount. Very small amount or little amount. What can you do with that? What will you get with that? So here they have kept a question mark also. What will you get from that? What happened with that amount? So by going into the lesson, at the end of the lesson, you will understand what did she get or her or what did he get. Pre-reading session. Observe the following picture and answer the questions. What can you say about the shop? When does one go to such shops? Why do you think the girl has come to the shop? What do you think the girl is saying to the shopkeeper? Does she look happy? What makes you think so? Who might be ill? So, you will get answers for all these questions if you observe the picture. 50% answers you will get from the picture. Rest of the answers you will get very clearly after completion of the lesson. Okay, what can you say about the shop? What shop is that? It's a medical store. When does one go to such shops? When anyone is ill, to take medicines, they go to that shop by taking the prescription given by the doctor. Why do you think the girl has come to the shop? You can observe here a little girl. What's the reason? Why did she come to that medical store? What do you think the girl is saying to the shopkeeper, the person who is selling the medicines? To that shopkeeper, what this girl is telling or speaking? Does she look happy? What can you feel by looking at her face? What makes you think so? What's the reason for thinking like that? Who might be ill? Who is ill? They're asking. So let us go into the session. What can a dollar and 11 cents do? An 8-year-old child, Tess, loved her brother Andrew. So, what is the name of the character here? The girl, little girl, whom you have seen in the medical store, her name is Tess. And how old is she? She is 8 years old. And what is the name of her brother? Andrew. She used to play with her brother. So every day she used to play with her. She has the habit of playing with her brother. One day Tess. What happened one day? Heard her parents talking about her little brother Andrew. So Tess heard or listened when her parents are speaking with one another, about whom they are speaking? They are speaking about Andrew. All she knew was that Andrew was very sick and her parents did not have enough money for the treatment. What did she know? What did she understand by their conversation? She understood her brother was ill or sick, not well, and they do not have enough money for the treatment. So what kind of decision they have taken? They were moving into a smaller house because they could not afford to stay in the present house after paying the doctor's bills. They were the tenant's children. Tenants means the people who rent the home, who rent the house to stay. Now they are shifting to another house and the size of the house is very small. What's the reason for that? They have paid all the doctor's bills. Now they don't have enough money to pay the rent also. That's the reason they are shifting to a very small house. He needed a costly surgery. Now who needs a costly surgery? Andrew. And there was no one to loan them the money. No one is there to give them money to loan them. Loan in the sense, so we borrow the money from others and again we have to return them with interest, with some extra money. As how do we make agreement? So her parents lost their hope and gave up their efforts. So at last what happened? We can't get our son treated. They have lost their hope and they felt very bad and sad by thinking about their son. When Tess heard her daddy say to her tearful mother, so who is crying here? Mother is crying. So her eyes were filled with tears and Tess heard the words of her daddy when he said some words to her mother. What did he tell? Only a miracle can save him now. Some wonderful event or something wonder should happen. That only can save him. The meaning of this word is also given in your glossary, children. She went to her home. She went to her room and pulled a jar of coins from a cupboard. So after listening this conversation, what did she do? She felt very sad and bad by thinking about his brother. And she went to her room and pulled a jar of coins. So there was a jar. It was filled with the coins. So parents give some money to the children to buy chocolates, biscuits like that. So some have the habit of saving little amount of money by spending some amount of money. So like that, she has saved some money. And to take out those coins from that jar, she has taken out the jar from a cupboard. She poured all the money out on the floor and counted it carefully. So what did she do? She poured all the money out on the floor. So, and started counting how much money is there. Holding the jar tightly, she made her way to the medical store and placed it on the glass table. So, counted the money and again kept them in the jar, holded the jar and went to the medical store and placed the jar on the glass table. So, there chemist asked, what do you want? Then, Tess answered, it's for my little brother. He is really, really sick and I want to buy a miracle. My little brother, his name is Andrew. He is not well. He is very sick. So I need a medicine. So the name of the medicine is miracle. I need that. I need to buy a miracle. I want to buy a miracle. We don't sell miracles here, child. So then chemist said very sadly, I'm sorry, we don't sell such kind of medicines here. Who said? Chemist said, smiling very sadly at the little girl. Listen, I have the money to pay for it. If it is not enough, I can try and get some more. Just tell me how much it costs. You please listen carefully what am I telling. I will give you the money to take miracle. So if the money what did I bring is not sufficient for you, I can gather some more money or I can bring some more money for you. Please tell me how much it costs. I need a miracle. I want my brother to be cured. I want to see him happily again. At the shop, there was a well-dressed customer. So there was a well-dressed customer in the shop. You can observe him here in this picture. So people standing inside the table are selling the medicines. Outside the table, they are purchasing them. There, if you observe, one person is there with apron. So about him, here we are speaking. At the shop, there was a well-dressed customer. He bent down and asked the little girl, "What kind of miracle does your brother need?" "I don't know." So what kind of miracle does your brother need? Then immediately that well-dressed customer bent down and asked him, "What kind of wonder does your brother need?" Then she replied, "I don't know," with her eyes welling up, started crying. Welling up means with she is crying. He is really sick and mommy says he needs an operation. And what her mother told, she needs an operation, but my daddy can't pay for it. So I have brought my savings. "How much do you have?" asked the man. So what did she tell? Mummy told he is really sick and daddy don't have that much money. So I brought my savings. Then immediately that man asked, "How much do you have?" $1.11, but I can try and get some more," she answered, barely audible. "If you need some more money, I will try and I'll bring some more money," she answered, but it is very slowly she answered. It is not at all audible. We can't hear also. "Wonderful," smiled the man. $1.11, the exact price of a miracle for your little brother. Very good. It's wonderful. The exact amount is that only. Your brother needs that much only to buy a miracle. He took her money in one hand and held her hand with the other. So that well-dressed customer taken her money and he had hold the hand of the Tess also. He said, "Take me to your home. I want to see your brother and meet your parents." Okay. "You take me to your home. I want to see your brother and I want to speak with your parents also. Let's see if I have the kind of miracle he needs. Let us see once if I have the miracle to get him cured." That well-dressed man was Dr. Carlton Armstrong, a famous neurosurgeon. So he is none other than Dr. Carlton Armstrong. He is a famous neurosurgeon, gives treatment related to nerves. So what did he do? He had joined Andrew in hospital and he operated him without any charges, means for free of cost. Then within a few weeks, what happened, children? Andrew was back at home and doing well. So at last, what happened? Andrew was very well and he was doing the things very nicely. Here you can observe the picture. That well-dressed customer has come to Tess home along with the Tess to examine the Andrew. And now surgery completed, everyone is happy in that home and mom whispered, "It was a real miracle and I surprise how much it would have cost. Anyhow, we should thank the God that Andrew is very well now." Tess is also very happy at the same moment. Tess smiled. She knew exactly how much the miracle cost. $1.11 plus the love of a little child. So Tess smiled and started speaking to herself. "I know the cost of that medicine. It is $1.11 plus love of a little child." How nice the lesson is, children. Hope you will enjoy by listening to this lesson. Glossary, meanings of the difficult words given in the text. Go through that, you can understand very easily. And textual exercises, you have to answer. Textual exercises, you will be able to answer after listening the lesson. Choose the correct answer and true or false statements. And even these also, exercise 3, 4 also related to lesson only children. Four, you can questions you can go through the material, and third one you can answer multiple choice questions. And now see vocabulary, very simple topic they have given here. See here, heard, poured, whispered. What are these? These are the, if you observe these sentences taken from the lesson, what can a dollar and 11 cents do? These are the past tense form of hear, pour, whisper, and past tense means it is used to indicate completed actions. And if you observe, these past tense is written in this way. How? Write the past forms of the following verbs. See here, change, ask, open, look, move, hesitate, play. And here they are asking you to write the past tense forms by adding ed or d. Means for some of the words d will be added, for some of the words ed will be added. How can you write without any spelling mistakes? Means if you are good at spellings, you can answer very easily. Now see, even this also, fill in the blanks they have given. First read all the sentences, then write the blanks from the given, then fill the blanks with the given options. And third Roman they have given antonyms. Antonyms means what children? Opposites. Healthy, unhealthy. Understood? Misunderstood. In the same manner they are asking you to write the opposites of the given words, and you have to add the correct prefix to write the antonyms or opposite. See here, miss, un, im, dis, in, ir. They have given you options also. Go through once and answer very carefully. And even here also they have given again related to past tense form only. And how past tense form is formed? Tess smiled, Tess answered, chemist said, she knew. Okay, these are the past tense forms of what children? Smiled. Smile is the present tense form, smiled is the past tense form. Answer, answered. Say, said. No, knew. So in the same manner, what is he going to tell you? Even changing into past tense forms also, we have three kinds. What are they? If we go through this, you can understand very easily. See here children, first one, reached, ed added. Add, added, ed added. Play, played. Touch, touched. Visit, visited. Avoid, avoided. Complete, completed. For these all, ed added to make the present tense form, to change it into past tense form. See here, died, leave, lived. So for this only D added. And keep, kept, sit, sat, teach, taught. For this what happened children? Some of the letters were changed in the word. Okay. And one more word you see. Cut. Put. All the three forms are same. So totally how many kinds we have observed children? In four types we can change present tense into past tense form. Revise very carefully. At the time of watching the video, place the textbook beside the mobile phone or a tab. Okay, then you can understand very easily if you go through the book simultaneously. Then you can answer in a better way. Okay children, even second exercise also you have to write the correct verb forms. So this is also related to past tense only. Even see third Roman, they have given some of the pairs of sentences. She used to play with her brother. Ismail used to play kabaddi in his childhood. Now he plays tennis. So used to is related to past tense form to tell about your past habits. Now here they are asking you to write five sentences about the things you used to do. About the things means about your past habits in your primary school. Okay, you can write them here only children, in the textbook they have given you place. And now diary entry. Diary writing. Diary writing means nothing but many have the habit of writing diary at the end of the day. The incidents what had taken place in that day. Just you observe the performa of the diary writing children. Right hand side top corner, day and month. Okay. Again, below that you have to mention the time also, at which time you are writing. Right hand side top corner. Okay, not top corner children, below this you have to write, below day and date. How did you mention? Here you observe, how did they write? Okay, their dear diary, just like a salutation or greeting. And you should write date and year. Okay, you can follow the same format. Here, who has written this diary writing? So, Tess has written her feelings in her diary. So, the love of a little child saved the life of her brother. Andrew recovered completely and returned home. Tess was very happy. So, she has written her feelings here. Once go through this, at last you have to sign. In the same way, now you have to imagine yourself as Andrew and you have to write the diary entry in your book. Now see next one. Picture based story writing. Here they have given you picture, some hints to write a picture. First observe the picture. What can you understand? What kind of idea you are getting by going through the hints given here? So starting should be nice and cohesion means connectivity should be there. At the same time, what should be there children? Conclusion also should be there. It should be there in a good way and no grammatical mistakes. Avoid grammatical mistakes. Follow the tense carefully. Okay, follow the tense carefully and write there. Better use past tense here. See here, fell, ill, quarreled, broke. Okay, so they have given starting also. Once they lived a farmer. So in past tense you have to write. See here, talking time. Here they have given you a debate. So like Dr. Carlton Armstrong. See, what did they give here? You have read in the story about the family struggle to save the life of their son, doctor. So, we have, what did we see here? As Tess parents are very poor, they don't have enough money to serve the poor. Then, Dr. Carlton Armstrong with his humanity levels. So, due to his kindness, as he can understand the feelings of the little child Tess, he has operated him for free of cost. So, Andrew recovered completely. Now, what are they telling you? All persons in the society should be given free medical and health care. You can discuss regarding this with your siblings at home, children. So, debate the above issue. So, here they have given you two or three students who support the idea that free medical and health care should be provided to everybody. Should sit one side. Who support that should sit one side. And who oppose that idea should sit another side. And other students will be watching them. Generally, it happens like that while the school is going on. Now, only your siblings will be there. No? One in a supportive way, one in a opposing way. You can discuss with your siblings at home. They have given you some guidelines also, children. You can start in this way. I agree with you, but I disagree with you, but I strongly feel that I oppose what you say. Now see second one. What can you observe in this picture? You can observe a ticket counter and many are standing there to take tickets. Now we are going to learn about some expressions. Show me the way to the railway station. Please show me the way to the railway station. Could you please show me the way to the railway station? About same concept only. But the way how do they seek the information is different. Show me the way to the railway station in a general way, informal manner. Please show me the way, formal way. Could you please show me the way in a more formal way? So in the same manner, here they have given you some of the sentences which indicate politeness. Okay. Now here they have given some of the expressions and you have to write them in a polite way by using please and could. Okay. Now see here, Imagine that you attended a function last evening. While everybody was in a happy mood, suddenly a snake entered the function hall. Somehow the organizers managed to catch it and hand it over to the zoo authorities. So what happened? So when you have attended a function, suddenly a snake appeared there. Some of the brave people caught it and handed over to zoo authorities. So in the same manner, what should you do? You have to tell about any incident that you have seen or listened to your friends. Now see dictionary skills, children. Here now we are going to learn about sa sound and sha sound. Sock, shock. See, she. Shake, shake. In the same manner, go through other words also. And project work, you can also collect a few stories like that of Tess from magazines and newspapers. You can also talk about them in the class. First, you collect them and file them. Stay home, stay safe, follow the precautions to avoid corona.